Hi everyone, welcome to my empty nest. I'm Cindy, thanks for stopping by. Tonight I'm making something called Cowboy Stew, and it only has three ingredients. And it's very good over mashed potatoes, egg noodles, or rice, which we're doing because we don't have either. We have to go to the store. So this is a chuck roast, but I cut a chuck roast that I had into three pieces because it's just my husband and I. So this is about a pound and a quarter of chuck roast, and I salt and peppered it already, and that's really all we need. I mean, this is plenty for us. So let me bring you over here to my pot, but first let me tell you the ingredients are the chuck roast or beef stew meat. You could do the original recipe calls for 3 pounds, but since it's just the two of us, I do one. But so this works with 3 pounds of meat too. One bag of onion soup mix. I make my own because I have to be gluten free. And then one can of cream of mushroom soup. And I also make my own. So, and it tastes so good. So I'm gonna put you down and show you what we do. Oops. Yep, that's right. Okay. Here's my pot. I'm just gonna put some oil, olive oil. And like I said, the original recipe called for 3 pounds of beef, which I don't need right now because it's just my husband and I. So you would put the 3 pounds of beef in here, and then it would cook in the oven at anywhere from 250 to 350. I have it on 275 for about 3 hours. And it's delicious. It is delicious. So let me see if my pan is ready. And I got this off a calendar, this recipe from a calendar. And I don't remember actually what type of calendar it was. Trying to see if that's good. Salt and pepper on the other side. A lot of fat in this meat. Like that, which you know gives flavor, but maybe too much fat. And I'm going to salt and pepper this side now. Very lightly with the salt because the mushroom soup has salt and so does the onion soup mix. I mean, I'm a fan of salt, but I don't know how much salt my husband likes, you know. I mean, I do, I just know he doesn't like as much as me. Okay, I'm just going to sear this on both sides, maybe this thick side too. And I'll bring you back when I'm ready to go to the next step. And it is a perfect day for a cup of tea. My type of day. Oh, just love fall. I just love how it's cool and then can be warm in the afternoon and then in the evening it's cool again. Oh, I just wish it would stay fall for, you know, all year round. green tea I'm drinking today. And that's good. Okay, I'll bring you back. Okay. Well, I know this part already because it's tiny. I don't know. Yeah, okay. Ooh. And all that, the bits on the bottom of the pan are going to give a tremendous flavor. Tremendous. And I'll show you how you get it up. In a minute, off the bottom of the pan. See, I just tested it. It came up okay. And now, I'm just going to let it sit on the thick side and brown. See all that brown stuff? Yummy flavor. And I'll probably try and brown on this side. This little piece is messing things up. Yeah. It shouldn't take long on this side. I'm just gonna brown this side and this side, and I'll bring it back and show you the next step. Okay, they're all browned, and I'm gonna put, this is equal to one bag of onion soup mix. I think I'm just gonna do maybe half, because like I said, this is a little bit over a pound, not 3 pounds. So I think that'll be excessive. Oh, this is what it says to do. Sprinkle it over. And I put the soup. This is the clear mushroom soup, and then it says to put 1 can's worth of water. So that, I looked at it, it's like 10.5, I think. Almost 11, so I'm winging it. It's probably close to 11. Okay. That's where the fondle come off the pan. Actually, I'm not going to use that. Now that it's called fond, the brown tip bits. And it'll come off so easily, and it'll give such good flavor to your dish. I remember that it's called fond because I used to watch a chef. He said, "I'm fond of fond." So that's how you remember what it's called. Just when you start feeling that it's getting easier to push this utensil around, then you know your brown fond is off the bottom. And the best part is the cleanup. There's one right there. There we go. Okay, turn that heat off. I'm just gonna try and flip this. Side. I don't want to go overboard. I don't want it to be too salty. I wish we had potatoes or even egg noodles, but we're going to have it over rice, which is fine. It'll be delicious. Okay, and then you put your cover on, wherever my cover is. Oh, okay. You put your cover on and you put it in the oven. And I put mine at 275, and I'm gonna check it after about an hour because it's such a small piece. And this holds heat really well. So I will bring you back when it's ready to be served, and I'll show you what it looks like. And if you're using a 3 pound beef, I would probably say if you're gonna put it on 350, maybe take the cover off and just mix it around once or twice. But since I'm just using one quarter pound or something, I'm not really sure. I'm just gonna leave the cover on. Okay, I'll bring you back. So I wonder if any of you are like me. While you're waiting for dinner to finish up and you're cleaning all the dishes, do you start cleaning the kitchen before you even eating dinner? I do, because it just helps. It helps with my fatigue, and then I have less to look, I have to look forward to cleaning less after dinner. And I always have to vacuum my floor and clean up after my bird here, my messy bird. He makes such a mess. Oh my gosh. But yeah, so that's what I do. I spray everything down. I let it sit for a minute or so, Unless I'm doing like chicken or beef, then I let it sit a little longer and then I clean it. So I just, so I have less to do after dinner, and I love that because after dinner, I like to sit on the couch and relax and either, you know, go on my phone or watch TV. I read at night in bed, so I don't read down here. But yeah, that's what I do. So I just wonder how many of you do that as well. And I'll be back when the dinner's ready. Okay. Oh boy. So mine cooked for about an hour and 35 minutes. And I had it on 275. And I just took a teeny, teeny bite and it melts. It melts in your mouth. It's so delicious. So delicious. I don't want to scrape the pan. Oh my gosh, so delicious. I'm just going to put this on a plate. And this tastes so delicious with mashed potatoes, but like I said, I have to go to the store. Oh my goodness, I have to show you. It's so tender. And I'm going to see if I could. I hate to scratch my pan here. You can use utensils like metal, but it's just, it'll scrape your pan. Like I shouldn't even have used those tongs. But anyway, so here is your gravy. Now you can put this in a pan and thicken it up, or you can put it on the stove here. Add some, maybe some a little bit of flour or cornstarch. I might do the flour, but gluten-free flour. Because there's some oil in there, though. I don't know what I'm gonna. You know what? It's been so long since I made this, I don't remember what I do. Well, I'm not gonna drain it, so I think I just will heat it on low and put some flour and thicken it up. And I'll show you what it looks like. I'm gonna loosely cover the meat, but it is melt in your mouth. Delicious. Delicious. So good. But yeah, it's been such a long time since I made it. I used to make the whole 3 pounds, sometimes more. Sorry. When the whole family was here. But this is a great Sunday dinner. It's not Sunday, but this is a great Sunday dinner to have. And I can't even tell you how easy it was. It's just so easy. So I'm going to let this cool. I'm going to thicken up the, I guess you would call it sauce, but not gravy really, but we're going to use it as gravy. But I remember making this with my kids, and that was when I was still eating gluten. And I would use the onion soup packet and the cream of mushroom soup can. And I'm going to tell you, the meat that I tasted tastes so much better with those two homemade items than it ever did with the cream of mushroom soup from the can and the envelope of the onion soup from the package. Wow, that just is so delicious. I'm going to move this over here for a sec. Scooch, scooch. Put this on very low and I'm going to thicken it up and I'll bring you back. I just can't tell you how good this is. You have to try it. Please try it. Your family will love you for it. I'll be back. Okay, I just want to show you that I'm waiting for my rice to be done. I just want to show you that these look like they're dry, but I promise you they're not. They look dry, but the reason is I couldn't cut it against the grain because it was almost next to impossible. So I cut it with the grain, which you're not supposed to do because, you know, you lose moisture. But it is still delightful, delectable. It's just so, so good and just melts in your mouth. So it's, if you make this and it looks like this, don't be alarmed because I'm telling you it's going to be delicious. and it's not dry at all. So I'm still waiting for my rice. I don't know what's taking so long, but I'll be back when I am to plate it all up and show you. And I've just been picking at it a little here and there and eating like little pieces that might be fat. And I also chopped off as much fat as possible on the edges. But yeah, and the sauce slash gravy, I'm not doing anything with it. I'm just keeping it on low. I'm not going to add anything because I think it's fine. You're just going to put it over the meat and put it over the rice. I think it'll be fine. So I'll be back as soon as my rice is ready. Okay, here's the end result. It doesn't look so great over rice, but and the coloring is just a little darker because I had it going on the stove, the sauce. But it melts in your mouth. I'm telling you, you will not regret it. I'm just going to put this in my mouth. You will not regret making this for your family. And it's just so easy. You just put it in the pot and put it in the oven. So easy. Excuse me. I know this looks dry over here. I know. But I promise you it's not. I don't know why it's coming up like that. But it's like I said before. I couldn't cut it against the grain the way it was going. But it melts in your mouth. It is so good. I sure hope you try it. I really hope you try it. And we're also going to have some... just to cut up cucumbers with salt. I just salted them. Yeah, I do eat a lot of salt, I guess. But I'm telling you, I'm glad I only put in half of the homemade onion soup mix because it would have been way too salty. And excuse my table. My daughter did her nails and it kind of ruined the whole table. But that's okay because it just shows people live here. And I'm okay with that. And I would show my face, but I think when I have my hair down, I look like the girl from Where the Crawdads Sing. Because my hair is kind of curly, so it's like, woo, all over the place. But I hope you try it, and I'll leave the link of the recipe below. I'll write it out. And I hope you enjoy it, and it's so easy. There wouldn't be a reason why you wouldn't try it. And it's delicious. So my name is Cindy. My channel is My Empty Nest. I really hope you'll consider subscribing because it helps me out so much. And I hope you have a wonderful evening. See you next time.